Starting off with finite state machine, it is the simplest machine to recognize the patterns. The finite automata or the finite state machine is an abstract machine which has five elements or tuple. It has a set of states and rules for moving from one state to another, but it depends upon the applied input symbol. So there are two type of machines with outputs. First is Moore machine and the second is Mealy machine. So Mealy machine is a finite state machine whose output depends on the present state as well as in the present input. So the six tuples are Q, which is the finite state of set of states. Then there's sigma, which denotes the input alphabet. Then there's capital delta, which denotes the output alphabet. Then there's delta, which is a transition function. Then there's lambda, which is an output transition function. And this Q0, which is the initial state. So from the state diagram, we can see that the output for any state depends not only on the present state, but also on the input. For example, in the present state B, for the input 0, the output is x2, but for input 1, the output is in the same state, the output is x1, the output becomes x3. So similarly for other states also, there exists particular output for a present state based on the input. In this example, in state Q0, if the input is 0, the output will be C, and if the input is 1, the output will also be C. In Q1, if the input is 0, the output will be A, but if the input is 1, the output will be C. Next come the Moore machine. Here it's also a finite state machine whose output depends only on the present state. This also has six tuples. And that is Q, which is the finite state of set of states. There's sigma, then capital delta, then the input transition, then there's x, which is the transition function, and Q0, which is the initial state. Now in the state diagram of Moore machine, here we can see that for any input, for a present state, the output is same, which only depends on the state. For example, in the present state, whatever input we give, whether 0 or 1, the output will be x2. Similarly, for the present state B, C and D, the output will be x1, x2 and x3 respectively for any input, whether 1 or 0. In this example of Moore machine, suppose the present state is Q0. If we give the input 0, then the output will be 1. And if we give the input 1, then the output will be still 1.
So now we will discuss about the conversion of both machines. In this slide, we will discuss about Mealy machine to Moore machine conversion. So as we know, in Mealy machine, output depends upon the both present state and present input. And in Moore machine, the output only depends upon the present state. To convert Mealy machine to Moore machine, we have to create a separate state for every new output symbol and distribute accordingly to a incoming and outgoing edges. So firstly, we have to calculate the number of different outputs for each state that are available in the state table of the Mealy machine. Secondly, if all the outputs of QI are same, we will copy the states, and if it has n distinct outputs, we will break into n states, QI, and where n is equal to 0, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. Finally, if the output of the initial state is 1, we will insert a new initial state at the beginning, which gives 0 as output. So moving on to the next slide, we will convert this Mealy machine into its equivalent Moore machine. You can see the transition diagram of this Mealy machine here. So here is the transition table for previous Mealy machine. So the state Q1 has only one output, and the state Q2, Q3 have both 0 and 1. So we will create two states for each state to convert. For Q2, the states will be Q20, which has output 0, and Q21, which has output 1. Similarly, for Q3, there will be two states like Q30, which has output 0, and Q31, which has output 1. So this will be the transition table for Moore machine. You can see that where Q1 has only one output, and Q2 and Q3 have both 0 and 1. And here is the transition diagram for Moore machine followed from the transition table above. So now we will convert Moore machine to Mealy machine in this slide. As we know, in Moore machine, the output is associated with every state, so we cannot directly convert Moore machine to Mealy machine, because Moore machine is one longer than the Mealy machine for the given output. So to do so, we have to take a blank Mealy machine transition table format, then secondly we will copy all the Moore machine's transition states into the blank table format, and lastly we will check the present states and their corresponding output in the Moore machine state table. If for a state QI output is M, then we will copy into the output columns of the Mealy machine state table wherever QI appears in the next step. Now we will convert this Moore machine into the Mealy machine. As you can see, its transition diagram.
So here, the transition table of the given Moore machine is as follows. So to convert the Mealy machine equivalent, so we have lambda dash q0 a, which gives 0 output. Similarly, lambda dash q0 comma b gives the output of 0. Similarly, we can also calculate lambda for state q1, which is as follows, gives 0 and 1 output. So here we have the transition table of the given Moore machine, which is as follows. So from here we can calculate the equivalent Mealy machine, which can be obtained as follows. Lambda dash q0 comma a is equal to lambda of q1, which gives the output 0. Similarly, lambda dash q0 comma b, which gives the output as 0 as well. So similarly, we can also calculate the lambda for state q1, which is given as lambda dash q1 comma a, which is equal to lambda q1 0. Similarly, lambda dash of q1 comma b gives the output 1. And similarly, we can also calculate the lambda for state q2, which gives output of both zeros. So hence the transition table for the Mealy machine can be drawn as follows, where we have two inputs and their corresponding outputs. Here in the below we can see the equivalent Mealy machine. So Mealy versus Moore machines. In Mealy machine, the output depends both upon the present state and the present input, but in Moore machines, output depends only upon the present state. Generally, the Mealy machine has a fewer states than the Moore machine, and the Moore machine, it has more states than the Mealy machine. Mealy machine is generally difficult to design as the output is placed on transitions. On the other hand, Moore machine is very easy to design as the output is placed on states. In Mealy machines, react faster to inputs, as they generally react in the same clock cycle. In Moore machines, more logic is required to decode the outputs, resulting in more circuit delays. They generally react one clock cycle later. Uses of Mealy and Moore state machines. Mealy state machines are used in processors due to their property of having many states.
And milli-state machines are also used to provide a rudimentary mathematical model for cipher machines. A multi-state machine is used as a write-enable in SRM, which stands for static random access memory, because of its speed. It is used in the SRAM because SRAM needs a level-sensitive control. Signal has to be asserted for a certain amount of time. So now we will discuss some of the gate level MCQs. So first we have this question, which states that the finite state machine described by the following state diagram with A as the starting state can be arc labeled as X slash Y, and X stands for 1-bit input and Y stands for 2-bit input. So in this problem, we first going to assume that the input string to be 1101. So first A comma 1 will correspond to B 0 1. Here we have the previous input bit plus the present input bit, which is equal to 0 and 1 output. Similarly, B 1 corresponds to C 10. So the previous input bit, which is 1, and the present input bit, which is also 1, gives us the output of 1 0. So next, C comma 0 corresponds to A 0 1. Here the output results into 0 1, and lastly we have B corresponds to 0 and A corresponds to 0 1, which gives us the input of 0 1 output. So the answer is option A, which states that outputs of the sum of the present and the previous bits of the input. Next. So here the question mentions that suppose we want to design a synchronous circuit that processes a string of zeros and ones. Given a string, it produces another string by replacing the first one in any subsequence of consecutive ones by a zero. So we have a following example given. So now we are going to solve this. So one second, hopefully, oh, this is not the final slide. No, previous slide only. What the previous? Yeah, so from here we can derive, we can make a table that the present state S, and there is input B, the next state T, and output Y will be there in the table, where present state 0 corresponds to the input B, next state T is equal to 0 and output Y equals to 0. So after deriving a table, we can reach to a conclusion that the terms T and Y in terms of S and B gives us a result of option B, which is T equal to B and Y equal to SB. Next slide. So here we have a question which states that the following diagram represents a finite state machine which takes as input a binary number from the least significant bit. So for this question, first we will take a binary number. Actually, this question states that the given FSM takes a binary number from LSB as input, and the given FSM remains unchanged till first one. So after that, it takes first one's complement for the rest of the input string. So we assume the input string to be 110010. Thus, according to the FSM, the output results into 001110. So the 2's complement of 110010 is equal to 1's complement of 110010 plus 1, which gives us the string 001110. So according to the result, the option B is it computes 2 complements of the input number is correct.
Thank you. Very good presentation. Okay, all the best. Thank you. Bye.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.